From this tutorial, we will start new series for AutoCAD Electrical. We have already created some of the electrical drawings in previous tutorials, but those were created using AutoCAD plain version. In this tutorial, we will create this schematic diagram again, but in AutoCAD Electrical. Right now, the user interface is grayed out. No command is active because there is no active drawing. At first, you will have to click on this arrow. Now, these are the regular AutoCAD templates. If we scroll it down, from here you can see that AutoCAD Electrical templates are started. Now, this ACE stands for AutoCAD Electrical, and they have provided templates as per different standards and different paper sizes. So you can choose as per your required standard and as per your required paper size. Suppose I will use this one, ACE NCB color. Click on it. So it will start drawing with one title block. Now here you can see that all the commands got activated. In AutoCAD Electrical, they have extra tabs such as project, schematic, panel, and so on. If you don't have these tabs, that means you don't have AutoCAD Electrical. You may be having plain version of AutoCAD or any other version. So for these tutorials to work properly, you need to have this AutoCAD Electrical only. And if you want to learn these basic commands, then I will give link to complete playlist in the description. So in this series of tutorials, we will not be covering these basic commands. We will directly start with electrical specific commands. In AutoCAD Electrical, at first you will have to create project. For project, you will have to click here on new project. Then here you will have to assign name to the project. Suppose I will name it as Electrical 1. Then here you can specify location for your project, or you can also browse the location. Then create folder with project name. If you tick here, it will create folder with the same name as the project. And project file have extension of WDP. Then if you already created some project and if you want to create new project with the setting of that old project, then you can browse that project here. Then click on OK properties. So here it has created project. Then in this library and icon menu path, in the project settings, if you click here on this plus sign, they have already selected some of the schematic libraries. So these are the folders which contains symbol drawings which we will be inserting in this drawing. So they have automatically added GIC 125 and GIC 125-1, and some other symbols are also there. So we will learn about this in detail in the coming tutorials. Target of this current tutorial is that we will create this schematic drawing. And we will not go in very depth in this current tutorial, but we will be going in more depths in the coming tutorials. And then they have selected here ACE-GIC menu. About all the other tabs, we will learn in the coming tutorials. Click on OK. Now we need to save this drawing. For that, click on Save here. Then I will name this also as an electrical one and click on save. So here drawing is created as electrical1.dwg. Then you will have to add this drawing to this electrical project. For that, right click on this electrical one and click on add active drawing. Then do you want to apply the project default values to the drawing settings? Click on yes. So here you can see that It has added that electrical drawing in the electrical project. Then we will start creating this schematic. At first we will create these three wires. Click on schematic. Then click on multiple bus. Then we will start in empty space. So select this empty space and go vertical. Then number of wires are 3. If those are not 3, click here and make them 3. Click on OK. Now here, for electrical drawings to create properly, you need to have this snap mode on. If it is in blue color, that means it is on, and if you click it, it will become off and it will be shown in black color. So click on it. Now it is on. Snap is on. So for this schematic drawing, snaps needs to be on. Then it will be easy to create the drawings. So because of that snap, actually your cursor jumps like this and it don't flow smoothly. So take your cursor here, click. Take your cursor below and click. Then zoom there. Then we will insert this circuit breaker. For that, click on icon menu. Then click on fuses and circuit breakers. So here is the fuses and circuit breaker. Click on this plus sign. And here is circuit breakers. Then I will choose this circuit breaker one pole. Then take your cursor here. Here it is showing midpoint, so we don't want to insert it at midpoint. Therefore, we will turn this object snap off. By clicking on it, you can turn it off. So here is object snap is off. So for electrical drawings, two things are important. One is you turn on snap mode on, and you turn object snap off. Now here, just click and click on OK. So all the other things we will learn in more details in the coming tutorials. By clicking on OK, it will add that circuit breaker and it will end this dialog box. But I want to add some more circuit breakers, therefore click on this OK repeat. Then click here, again OK repeat, click here and click on OK. Then I want circuit breakers from this side. For that, take your cursor here near this red symbol, that is scoot. Click on this arrow and click on this reverse flip component. Then click on flip, click on OK. Then we have to click on this component, but because of this snap mode, it is not selecting that component. So while working, if you face any problem because of the snap mode, you can temporarily turn it off. You can see that you can easily select this component. So click on it. Click all the other components. Then I want to move these tags at proper locations. For that, click here on this arrow and click on Move Show Attribute. Then select these attributes, press enter, then specify base point, take your cursor below and click. So here they are placed properly. Press enter, then again turn this snap mode on by clicking on it. Zoom minus. Then next is this relays. Click on icon menu. Click on relays. Then I want relay with pins. Then take your cursor here and click. OK repeat. Click. OK repeat. Click. And OK. Then next is this overload. Click on icon menu. Then click on motor control. Then here is the overload. Click. Then for other point of overload, I want to write here T1. So here in pin 2, I will write T1. OK repeat. Click T2. OK repeat. click T3. Okay, here this overload is added. Then you can again move this attribute. For that, click here on move show attribute. Then again make snap mode off, select these attributes, enter, specify base point and give proper location and click. Press enter, make snap mode on, zoom minus, then add this motor, again click on icon menu, click on motor control, click on 3-phase motor, then click on this endpoint and click on OK. So here this motor is added. Then next is to add this transformer. Then we will create this connecting wires. Click on icon menu, click on fuses, circuit breakers, click on transformer, and suppose I will add it here. Click on OK. Then we will add this wire. Click on wire. And again to catch point here, make snap mode off. Then click here on this component, take your cursor on this side and click here. So here it has been created. Then again click on wire. Then take your cursor to this relay and click. Then make snap mode on, take your cursor above. Now this wire is getting interference with circuit breakers. So what we will do, at first we will shift these circuit breakers above and then again create this wire. Press escape. To shift these circuit breakers, click here on scoot. Then select these circuit breakers, take your cursor above and click. Then to align these remaining circuit breakers, click on this arrow and click on align. Then turn off this snap mode so that it will be easy to select. Then at first you will have to select a component with respect to which you want to align. I will select this CB1, then select components to align. So click on these two components and press enter. So here those got aligned properly. Then again click on wire, then click on this relay, then make snap mode on, take your cursor above and click, then take it below, then again make snap mode off and click here on the transformer. So here this wire is created. Then next is to create these fuses. For that click on icon menu, click on fuses, then click on fuse, then make snap mode on and click here, then press enter to repeat the command. Again click on fuses, click on fuse and click. So both fuses has been placed. Then next is to create this wire. Click on wire, then make snap mode off, then click here, then make snap mode on and take your cursor on this side, click, take it above, click, take it on this side, click, then again make snap mode off and click. So here this wire is created. Then next is to place this stop push button which is normally closed. Click on icon menu, click on push buttons, then here is the push button normally closed. Click on it. Then make snap mode on so that it will catch it perfectly and click. So whatever you write in the description, that will be placed near your component. So here I want to write stop. Type stop and click on OK. Then next is to create this push button, which is normally open. Again, click on icon menu, click on push buttons, then click on this push button normally open and click here, and here type it start. Okay. Then to move these attributes, click on move show attribute. Then make snap mode off so that it will be easy to select the attributes. Click on the attributes to move. Then press enter, specify base point, take your cursor below and click. Then select this attribute, PB2, press enter, specify base point, take it below and click. Then press enter. Then next is to create this wire. Click on wire, make snap mode on, then click, take it below, click and click. Then to add this relay, click on icon menu, click on relays and click on relay normally open and click. Okay. Then next is to add this motor coil. Again click on icon menu, click on motor control and click on motor starter coil and click and okay. Then right now I don't want to show these attributes. For that, click on this arrow near move show attribute, click on hide attribute single pick. Then again these attributes cannot be selected because of snap mode. Click here on the snap mode to turn it off and select these attributes, press enter. Then this relay normally closes. Click on icon menu, click on relays and click here on relay normally closes. Make snap mode on and click and OK. The next is to add these line numbers. For that, click here on this arrow near wire numbers and select 3-phase. Then I want to add only L1, L2 and L3. So I don't want this base. So remove it and click on OK. Then select wire L1. So this is my L1. Then L2 and L3. So you will have to click everywhere and click on OK and press escape. So here line numbers has been added. So this circuit is ready. Then next is to add details to this title block. First we will add this project description. Just double click on this project description. And here you can place your value. Suppose I will type here project of ABC company. Same way you can change your title one. Suppose title one is schematic diagram. Suppose size is B. Suppose the revision is 0. Then drawing number is something like this. So in this way you can add all the other details and click on OK. So those details will be updated in your title block. So this schematic is ready. In the next tutorial we will cover next set of topics and we will learn AutoCAD electrically in more details. So thanks for watching. We will stop here.